Welcome everyone to continue our 5G course. Yesterday, we have already introduced some developments and evolutions of 5G. Actually, we mainly introduce what is 5G and then the driving force of 5G development. Simply introduce that 5G may support some new applications in the future, especially some applications in vertical industries. Today, we are going to take a look. We say 5G has many strong capabilities, right? Including the higher speed we mentioned, then lower latency and greater connectivity. Then we want to enable vertical industries through these three key capabilities and then empower the data economy. But what means do we use to achieve such higher speed, lower latency, and greater connectivity? Actually, it's what we're going to introduce in this lesson, that is, 5G is through some new network architectures, including some new key technologies to achieve higher speed, lower latency, and greater connectivity. We will mainly look at this lesson, the architecture and key technologies of the 5G network. First of all, we mentioned that 5G enables vertical industries, then it puts higher requirements on our entire network, including the three capabilities and slicing we mentioned. Then we are going to take a look, 5G is through what means what technologies to obtain such key capabilities. The first one is we are going to take a look what are the key capabilities of 5G. Actually, we mentioned some in our course yesterday. The second one we are going to take a look, in order to meet such key capabilities of 5G, what changes have we made in network architecture and the selection of key technologies. Finally, we look at the network security of 5G. We also briefly mentioned in the development trend yesterday. This part of the course content, we will take a detailed look. What new technologies does 5G have in network security to ensure the security of our data based on the 5G network? The first one is our key capability. We briefly mentioned the key capabilities yesterday. Then we will review it here. The first one is our vision of 5G. This is what we mentioned yesterday, IMT 2020. This is the legal name of our 5G. ITU defines three application scenarios for our 5G network. They are our eMBB, URLLC, and mMTC. But we also mentioned yesterday in the 3GPP, R15 and R16 protocols. Actually, we mainly define the technical standards for the eMBB and URLLC application scenarios about mMTC because considering to maintain a certain continuity with the previous NB-IoT and eMTC. So the technical standards for the mMTC part will be implemented in the 3GPP, R17 and later standards. We also mentioned these three application scenarios. They brought out three key performance indicators. Our downlink rate needs to reach 10G even above, then the delay must be controlled within 1 millisecond, then the connectivity needs to achieve 1 million per square kilometer. Of course, this is from the perspective of these three application scenarios. Actually, we can also look at it in detail. The whole 5G network has some enhancements in key performance indicators compared to 4G through this picture we can see. This is a comparison of IMT 2020 and IMT Advanced. IMT Advanced is actually our LTE enhancement. Then it's what we discussed before. When we talk about LTE, actually it corresponds to our IMT Advanced. Then we see this inner circle is technical indicators or key capabilities of IMT Advanced. The outer circle is 5G technical indicators and key capabilities of IMT 2020. By comparison, we see that the overall key capabilities of the 5G network will be enhanced compared to 4G. For example, the peak rate we are concerned about in the 4G era, we say we have LTE, LTA. Through the technical enhancement of LTA, we can achieve a downlink rate of 1 Gbps. But in the 5G era, we are 10 Gbps or even above. Then another one is our user experience rate. Actually, when we say 10 Gbps, even say 20 Gbps, these are all some peak rates, the user experience rate that our users can really feel. Actually, it's more important for users in the 4G era. Our user experience rate, it might be about 20 Mbps, 30 Mbps, 40 Mbps, 40 Mbps. This is quite common. Of course, we may go to some places where the signal coverage is not very good. It might only be a few megabytes. But in the 5G era, the user experience rate we define, the downlink needs to reach 100 Mbps in this way. Compared to 4G, our user experience rate has greatly improved. Actually, for ordinary users, we are more concerned about our experience rate. And another one is spectral efficiency. We also mentioned this yesterday, wireless network, we have several very important resources. And the most important resource is our frequency resource, because frequency is a non-renewable resource and the frequency resource is relatively limited. Then how to improve spectral efficiency? Well, this is what we are very concerned about. We require that in the 5G era, spectral efficiency is at least 3 times higher than 4G, at least a 3-fold increase. Of course, how do we calculate this spectral efficiency? We can also base it on the peak rate divided by bandwidth. We can roughly estimate our spectral efficiency in the 5G era, it will be 3 times that of 4G or even more than 3 times. And another one is mobility. In the 5G era, we need to support high-speed mobile business scenarios. Actually, in the 4G era, we can also support some of these. For example, applications in high-speed rail scenarios, applications in high-speed mobile scenarios. Of course, we talked about the application scenario of high-speed rail generally within about 350 kilometers, but in the 5G era, even more than 3 times improvement, another aspect is mobility. In the 5G era, we need to support high-speed mobile business scenarios. Actually, in the 4G era, we can also support some of these, such as applications in scenarios like high-speed rail applications in high-speed mobile scenarios. Of course, we mentioned the application scenarios of high-speed rail generally within about 350 kilometers. But in the 5G era, we will support higher speed mobile scenarios, such as 500 kilometers per hour. The application of such high speed mobile scenarios, another one is latency. We mentioned this yesterday, we want to achieve this kind of 1 millisecond. Control of such latency. Another one is what we call connection oriented, a connection density. This will be a significant improvement compared to 4G we need to achieve per square kilometer. More than 1 million connections. Another one is energy consumption in the 5G era. We require it to have lower energy consumption than 4G network. There should be a significant reduction because we said in the 5G era, our frequency band will be relatively high. For example, we use a frequency band like the C band. Of course, in the future, in some hotspot capacity areas, we may also consider using millimeter waves. But the problem with these high frequency bands is that the coverage will be relatively poor. So we need to use more sites to cover. This means that the number of network elements in the entire network will be more. In fact, the overall network energy consumption will be greater. And similarly, because our entire system, the bandwidth used will also be larger and larger. So how to reduce network energy consumption implementing the concept of green-based stations is actually quite important. Because for telecom operators now, in their operating expenses, there may be close to 15% to 30%, but the data will vary for different operators. Some advanced operators, they may be able to control network energy consumption in operating expenses to around 15% to 20%. There may be some relatively backward operators. Their network energy consumption in the entire operating expenses may account for 30%. So controlling network energy consumption is a very important means of saving. In fact, the saved network energy consumption is actually our profit. Another point is our regional traffic capacity. We see that in the future 5G era, we need to support per square meter 10 Gbps of this kind of regional traffic. In this case, our requirements for network capacity will actually be higher. And this is from these key performance indicators. We did some comparisons between 4G and 5G. We will find that 5G has a significant improvement in these key performances. There will be a significant improvement when we want to achieve such a significant performance improvement. In fact, this is based on our use of new network structures and some new key technologies as the basis. We can achieve such a key capability improvement. Let's take a look in order for our 5G to achieve such high business capabilities or key capabilities. What are some of the challenges we face first? Let's look at the experience rate we want to achieve 100 megabytes, even 1 Gbps user experience rate. In fact, this challenge is quite big, right? Our current user connections in a single base station in the case of a single cell may want to achieve this kind of 100 megabytes to 1G experience rate. Sometimes it may be difficult. Especially when our users are at the edge of the cell, your signal conditions will be relatively poor. It's difficult to achieve such a 100 megabytes, even 1G user experience rate. But through this kind of interstation cooperation, that is, our users may be connected to two cells at the same time or even two different base stations. We gain some gains through such interstation cooperation to allow users to get a better experience rate. This is actually the meaning of our interstation cooperation, but how to achieve interstation cooperation? Then we have to ensure that these base stations can be interconnected. We base on IP network to achieve interconnection, or we say narrowly based on IPRAN network, right? When we have some other solutions based on such an IP network to achieve interconnection, but at present, the ability of interstation cooperation is insufficient. When we are now in 4G, we have achieved interstation communication. But the cooperation ability, some cooperative features are still insufficient by the time of 5G. We need to make up for the shortcomings to gain stronger interstation cooperation capabilities. In this way, we can improve our user experience rate, especially to improve the experience rate of our cell edge users. Another point is that we say traffic density, right? Traffic density is getting higher and higher. We will find that terminals are everywhere, users are everywhere, and their demand for traffic is getting higher and higher. So the overall demand for traffic density will also be higher and higher. In this case, it puts pressure on our entire transmission network, or we call it the backhaul network. The pressure on its capacity is quite large. At this time, we may need to consider how to expand our backhaul network or how to expand our transmission network to cope with higher traffic density. Another point is that we say future 5G will face a scenario of Internet of Everything. The connection capability of the network, it is also a challenge. We said in the 4G era, each cell we can probably support 10K, that is a connection capability of 10,000. But in the 5G era, the connection capability will have a lot of high improvements. In this case, it puts higher demands on our entire network signaling processing. In this case, signal overload in our network may occur. How do we overcome through some technical means or to reduce the impact of signal overload? This is also something 5G needs to consider. Of course, it includes how to reduce the consumption of header redundancy for some small packet services. This is also very important. Another point is what we call low power consumption and low cost, because now operators are facing operational pressure, including our three domestic operators. The profit margin is relatively high to some of these Western ones. For example, in Europe, where telecommunications business is more developed. In fact, the profits of telecom operators are relatively low. They are all single digits, right? Then how to go through this low power consumption, this green base station solution to reduce our operating costs, including reducing our capital expenditure during the construction phase. Actually, for operators, this is very important. And then we need to consider how to reduce our operating costs, including reducing our capital expenditure during the construction phase. This is very important for customers. Of course, the last point is that we are targeting some such as vehicle networking, intelligent manufacturing, etc. In such application scenarios, it requires high consumption and low latency services. But for high consumption and low latency services, especially for vehicle networking, this low latency, how to achieve this low latency? Actually, for our transmission path, how to optimize our transmission path? This is also required. Our current transmission paths may be somewhat lengthy. We need to optimize through some technical means. Reduce the delay of our transmission network to meet our high consumption and low latency application requirements of these vertical industries. This is what we have summarized from the key capabilities dimension. It has some new requirements for our 5G network. For example, we need to enhance the collaborative capabilities between stations and then increase the capacity of the backhaul network, etc. Another point is from the operation perspective. From the perspective of network operation, we also need to propose some new requirements because the future network will become more and more complex. The number of network members in the network will increase. How do I perceive the entire network? How to coordinate the operation of the entire network? Actually, this is for network operations. It puts forward higher requirements. In this case, we may need to use some big data means of artificial intelligence to achieve intelligent operation and maintenance, to reduce our operation and maintenance pressure, improve our operation and maintenance efficiency, improve our operational level. Of course, another point is that our network has evolved. There may be 4G in our network, there will be 5G, and maybe some new systems will come in the future. How to coordinate between networks? This is very important. How to coordinate between 4G and 5G, including we may have in the network, there will be existing 2G and 3G. In this case, how to coordinate well between different system networks, ensure such business efficiency. This is also very important. This is what we have summarized, some challenges faced by the 5G network. We need to update the network architecture, enable new key technologies to meet these challenges. These are some important focuses on our 5G journey. This is what we summarized in yesterday's evolution course, DDA part of the summary. For example, we say that the delay should be controlled within 1 millisecond. Then the connection capability, our traffic, then support high-speed scenarios, then support flexible slicing, because the future 5G network needs to enable vertical industries and our different vertical industries. Its requirements for network capabilities are different. How do we enable different application slices through a physical network to meet different vertical industries? The demand for business, this is a very important slicing capability. And for our 5G network, we will put forward such requirements, right? Low latency, large traffic, support more connections, support higher speed mobile scenarios to support slicing capabilities. How are these capabilities implemented? Actually, it is divided into two parts. Through our new network architecture, through our new wireless air interface technology to implement these key performance indicators. For example, our new architecture, we propose a physical network, enable multiple slices. This way, to meet the differentiated needs of vertical industries and the new air interface technology, we will use some new modulation coding methods, new waveforms, new multi-antenna technology to provide higher speed, higher spectral efficiency, lower latency, stronger coverage network. In this way, let 5G meet our key capabilities. Let 5G meet some of our key capabilities like this.